Good morning. I called this meeting together today after speaking to a few of us about...
My name's Tim Milkins. I'm a teacher in a technology and applied sciences department. I currently teach in a school called Abbotsleigh on Sydney's North Shore. It's an independent girls' school from preschool age through to the end of year 12. Abbotsleigh has approximately 900 students in the senior component of the school.
What I'd like for us to do, and it's why I've prepared a series of these feedback sheets, is actually look at some of the student examples of work and have a try of using this marking criteria with those tasks. Mm-hmm. There's one for each of the computers, and we'll log into our machines and work in pairs to do it.
Today I've asked to hold a meeting with three of my colleagues from the Technology and Applied Sciences Department to talk about the marking process and the marking tools that we've been using to assess student work. We're worried about, the consistency of the marking tool itself and also the consistency of the judgment of staff as they use the tool.
All right, that looks good. All right, let's get back and we'll talk about what we've just looked at.
Although I'm not a head teacher or a head of department, I took the initiative to develop a new marking tool because I have a few roles within the school that enable me to see how the students are working and how they value clear feedback from the assessments and the tasks that they complete.
So with this as a marking tool then, I mean we've come up with results and some marks there. How have you found it?
I think Terry and I found it quite good. I like being able to have this beside me, so I could sort of do in here. I'm not quite sure what you anticipated us to do with these squares. I've just coloured mine in and Terry's ticked hers. equally, I guess someone could put the numbers in there, like 4 and 3 and 5. But I guess that's not so important, but what is important is clearly given a pattern of what they've done, which I think is good.
I feel it is incredibly important to get my colleagues' judgments on this tool so that together we can have an educated view on how to develop our assessable process.
Do you think as a tool this could be useful for us to establish consistency and, you know, comparable judgment with the way that we're working as teachers in our marking?
I think, the mood that we've had just then in our discussions is definitely in agreement to that. Mm. Yeah, that it certainly would help to build consistency and between individuals' tastes and observations. You know, it takes out the bias that could possibly be there between one person and another.
By involving my colleagues in developing the marking tool, they're going to have ownership and understanding in regards to what the new marking tool is, how it functions, and together we can work on how to improve it for use into the future in our department.
At first, it took me a while to sort of switch between the two, just trying to make sure I was really being fair to the student in terms of, you know, is that a 5 or a 4 or a 3? And I think if we benchmarked, it certainly would make that sort of thinking a lot clearer. But once I sort of got into it and started using the key words, the language, and thinking about that in terms of what I'd seen, I think that it was really helpful.
Great. So, all right, well, I suppose in regards to try it, do you think we could try this for a small period or maybe a particular year group?
Well, let's see, why not.
From here, there will be a meeting to actually put this new marking tool into an upcoming assessment task for the students to perform. From there, after the assessment is completed, we will meet again after marking to actually establish the effectiveness of the marking tool within that task.
Great. Thank you very much for coming today.
Okay.
Thanks
for the meeting. Thanks, mate.
How do you support moderation activities with colleagues that address school and cross-school comparisons of student learning? What strategies have you used to ensure consistency and comparability of colleagues' judgments when assessing student learning?